It's an absolutely empowering event. And do you know what? I will be completely honest. I didn't know about We Day until someone said, "Oh, do you want to come and speak along?" And I couldn't believe I've not heard about it before. It's just, it's a moment where you can just inspire so many people in one event, and I think it's incredible because, as someone, you know, with a disability growing up, I didn't have that. I didn't have anyone else to look up to and say, do you know what, I can achieve my dreams. I can, you know, go and explore the world and do what I want to do. And so to be able to do that for other people, to help, you know, people aspire, to inspire, I just think is the best feeling ever. And I'm really excited.
And why do you think in 2020 it is so vitally important that we do inspire and empower that next generation of people?
I think it's really, really important. I mean, you know, technology is continuously advancing. You know, I think the world is becoming a more inclusive place. You know, people are finding their identity and becoming more comfortable with who they are, you know, whatever they are. You know, as I was growing up with a disability, you know, it wasn't something that was accepted very much, particularly in the education system. And I just think it's important for people to know that it's okay to be unique, because that's actually, as soon as you let go of other people's stereotypes and judgments about you, you become your own person, and then you can do anything. And so I think it's so important to do that.
And in terms of that tolerance and inclusiveness, are there particular changes that you would like to see, either in education or just in a wider social context?
Absolutely. I mean, again, going back to the whole disability situation, I've had people saying to me time and time again, don't bother doing this, don't bother applying to medical school, don't bother going out and doing this and that because you have a disability. And I think actually, you know, I say this in speech later, you know, ignorance is actually the greatest form of deafness. You know, if we don't learn about other people, then we will never be tolerant. And until we make it a normal topic of conversation, difference will be a taboo. So I think it's really essential that we keep talking about it, we keep in the conversation, so that, you know, because diversity is an amazing thing. And I do a lot on diversity. I do a photography project, believe it or not, as a visually impaired person, which celebrates diversity. And I just think it's an incredible thing.
And in terms of your own projects, your own endeavours, looking to the rest of the year and beyond, what are you excited about and what should we be excited about?
Oh, I got loads to look forward to. I mean, obviously, I have my medical school finals, which are the priority. I'm actually coming to the end of writing a book, which I'm hoping to finalise this summer. So watch this space. I'm also really excited for my Faces of the NHS project, which is a project that celebrates diversity, breaks down stereotypes within the healthcare system. I mean, very proud of the NHS, as a future doctor myself. Lots to look forward to, the book, traveling. I'm hoping to do a few documentaries on the way as well. So yeah, watch this space.